So Spencer County woman is on a mission to make sure everyone buckles up. It started with a simple Facebook page, and now she's created a website that people are noticing and getting behind, including the police. WLKY's Daniel Kemp joins us live now to explain why she's doing it. Daniel?
January 18th, two teenage girls are killed when their truck flips on Mike Brown Road. Police say they weren't wearing seatbelts.
Our accident reconstructionists, they'll pinpoint if speed was a factor, if anything else was a factor.
It's a story that has grabbed the attention of this close-knit community and many of the people living in it.
I can only imagine the pain of losing a child.
Kristen Young is one of those people.
You never know what could happen.
Last week, Young started a Facebook page called Buckle Up Spencer County. It's part of a grassroots effort to raise awareness about seatbelt safety.
By that night, there was 40, and then the next morning, there was, a few hundred, and then by that evening, there was over 700.
More than 1,200 people are members of the group, and Young says her cause continues to grow. She's now running the website Buckle Up Kentucky.
People are talking about it, and, 99.999% of everything I've heard is excellent feedback.
And I think it's a great thing.
Sheriff Buddy Stump says the message is important. The websites list statistics as well as stories from survivors saved by their seatbelts.
Maybe because of this and with the help of this website and stuff they're starting, maybe it will cause some other lives to be saved by just having seatbelt awareness.
Which is all Kristen Young really wants.
You don't have to run into a burning building or, do anything extreme to be a hero. You just need to buckle up, teach your children to buckle up, and when anybody gets in your car, tell them that they have to buckle up.
And according to the National Highway Traffic Administration, 557 people died in 2010 as a result of traffic crashes in Kentucky. 310 of those people were not wearing seatbelts. I'm Daniel Kemp, WLKY News.